Where's everybody? Call Ricardo. Jabril, did the meeting move? Where's everyone?
No. Actually, it was postponed, so there won't be a meeting today.
Mm-hmm. Under whose orders?
Mine.
Jabril, you have a lot of nerve coming here, trying to turn everybody in this company against me.
No, that's all you're doing. All of these unnecessary, crooked business tactics you have going on. And all for what? Power?
You damn right.
But you don't even see that this endless quest you have going on only helped you lose it. And why? Because you are just threatened over pretty much nothing. And you know the sad part about it all is? You don't even realize none of this, none of it belongs to you.
Jibra, I am CEO of this company. Don't you ever forget that.
But here's what you have forgotten. The company belongs to Baron and the board of directors. This little CEO spot that you have, it's a joke. Because you're just a placeholder.
And you're just a pawn for Catherine and Tessa. You're too naive to see that they're just using you because they can't get to me. And besides, you don't even want to be here anyway.
Hey, I'll be the first to admit this is not my choice of career path.
Then get the fuck out! Stop thinking you can run this company better than I can, because the truth is, no one can.
Yeah, but the board of directors seem to think otherwise. You see all these blood, sweat, tears you've been putting into these multi-million dollar projects and such?
Yeah,
doesn't hold a candle when they take into consideration how unethical Phallon Davenport has been.
Jabril, you're new to this. This is the way businesses are ran. You get things done by any means necessary.
Sister, I'm not a fool. I know how it's supposed to go. Hell, be deceitful, be underhanded, backstab, do it all. But your problem is you don't know how to cover your tracks.
So you mean to tell me that you think that Dad built this company by being some ethical businessman? Dad broke every rule there was to break. And how do I know? Because he taught me. It's just the way that it's done. It's just the way that you conduct business.
But I know what he's done. Hell, I know what he's still doing. But the big difference is between you and him is that you let emotion drive you, not the needs of the business.
It was all for the business, Jabril.
No, it's for personal gain. For Fallon's personal gain. You know what? That little measly 25% of moms, that would not have changed your standings here at this company.
How do you know? You would say anything, being as though she was going to give the money to you.
So you truly believe that if you were the CEO that you were when you first started, the directors would allow you to be replaced all because of some measly shares?
Hey, Kiko,
shut the fuck up!
Look, Kiko, I'm sorry. I can explain everything that happened.
Save it. Your apologies mean nothing to me.
So you just not gonna let me explain what happened?
So how long have you been fucking my man, you bitch?
Look, Kiko, Winston's not your man.
Excuse me?
Bitch, you heard me. He's not your man. Look, Kiko, wake up. He never will be. I'm sorry.
So I guess you was telling yourself while you was on your knees, sucking his dick, and getting teabagged, you nasty little queen.
You really are mad for somebody that's never claimed you, never will claim you.
Say who?
Says Winston.
That's a damn lie.
I mean, you can always ask him yourself.
You know what? Phallon was right about you. You have no problems with opening your legs to men that doesn't belong to you. And you proved her right.
What does Phallon have to do with this, Kiko?
I just said it.
You know what? I don't get you. You really think Fallon's your ally after you blackmailed her?
That was just business, and you know it.
Yeah, business. Kind of like the agreement that she had with Winston. The only reason he dated you was to keep you happy and keep you off of her ass. It was all a big setup.
I don't believe anything you're saying.
Oh, well, I mean, Winston actually told you that night your little skinny ass came in there doing that little strip tease or whatever the fuck it was.
You was there?
Kiko, I was in the other room. And when your tired ass left, I finally got the full story of what was going on.
So you probably was laughing at me the whole time.
Laughing, no. A little shocked, repulsed, and a little disgusted, actually.
I'm not sure, Jabril, but what I do know for a fact is, if you controlled the majority of the shares, Tessa would have had me pushed out, Cat would have been in Dad's ear. I'm not an idiot.
Come on, give Dad a little bit more credit. Cat does not have that much influence
you
on that man.
You still make excuses for everyone.
Phallon, you are so consumed with other people that it clouds your judgment. If you worried less about people that don't even have a say in the day-to-day here at Davenport Industries, you would be the CEO that you once were.
Even on my worst day, I made multi-million dollar deals. On my worst day. So truth is, I'm actually better at this job than Dad is. There's no replacement for me, Jabril. Even if you replace me, there's still no replacement for me.
All that said, the board thinks you should step down.
I will not do no such thing.
Okay, let me put it in layman's terms for you.
Okay.
The board is removing you as CEO of Davenport Industries.
Really? I'd like to see them try. And plus, Dad wouldn't let them do that to me anyway.
Yeah, it was a unanimous decision.
I know too much about this company, and I know way too much about this business to not have heads rolling behind me, including yours, dear brother.
Phallon, I'm not your enemy. I never was.
Right.
So all that should be put in, that energy into something else, okay? Because even when the job was mine and it was given to you by default, I could care less about it, honestly. So, that's something you should think about. This is your life. It's not going to be mine.
So you say. Where the hell is Winston? Winston! Winston, call me back as soon as you get this. It's an emergency.
Our friendship is over. You're dead to me.
Well, look, Kiko, I don't know what to say at this point. I mean, you gotta ask Phallon about this. I'm out of here.
Well, I'm not done.
You lucky you're a woman, and you lucky I gotta give that to my man. Girl, bye. I'm out of here. Jail once. I'm not going again behind you.
Well, you gonna go again? If you swear to God, if I see you, I'm gonna fuck you up even worse. Got my fucking unit all messed up.
Bitch, fuck you!
Vic, what are you doing here?
Shut up and sit down.
No, I'll stand. What's with the hostility?
that street trash you have here, she's gotta go. Where is she?
She's not here right now.
Victor, you find her, you pack up her shit, and you put her out. She's got to go.
She's not going anywhere.
Over my dead body.
Well, then you're gonna become a corpse. Because again, she is not going anywhere.
All of a sudden you decide to grow some balls, big brother? It's a little too late for that. No one defies my orders, Victor.
Look at you. Letting that little mafia queen go right to your head. A little bit much, huh, sis?
Victor, you're the only man that I know that has an affinity for sluts and whores. You know, I hope this one bleeds you dry.
Trust me, I'm keeping her on a short leash.
Trust you? Trust you? Victor, you have the track record of an aging racehorse that should be shot so it's put out of its fucking misery.
What, are you gonna shoot your brother?
You wanna find out?
Look, she ain't going nowhere. We're husband and wife now.
You what?
She is a Diluca.
Victor, if you were not my brother, I would spit in your face. How could you be so stupid?
Look, it's all part of a plan. I have to keep her close. I need to protect my investment.
What are you talking about?
Look, you gotta trust me on this. I have a plan in place that's gonna give me access to a huge chunk of the Davenport fortune.
You know, I don't understand what obsession you have with those morons.
Look, please, sis, trust me on this. I know I've been fucking up lately, but I'm gonna prove myself. This is gonna work.
Victor, ever since I put you in... Ever since I've trusted you a little bit and given you the lead to take care of the business and opportunities, it's been one disaster after the next. First you undersell the Jersey Farm property to that Davenport woman, and then the one chance that you have to finally go legit, you fuck it up by letting her double cross you. And now Eve?
Come on, please. It's all part of a plan. I will tell you this works.
What plan? What are you talking about?
Look, Eve has a son. She has up at a boarding school in upstate New York. All right, just listen. Just listen to me. All right. He is the son of a Davenport heir. And he has no idea he has a son.
So you're playing daddy? Who gives a shit?
Look, listen to me, all right? I'm married to Eve now, all right? I'm gonna adopt her son. Get it?
I can see where this is going. Carry on.
Okay, well, let's see if, something mysteriously happens to Eve. She disappears. Who has full custody and is the basic father of the child at this point?
So you're gonna whack the bitch?
I haven't thought about it yet.
How much you think this kid is worth?
Millions. We're sitting on a gold mine, sis. Trust me, a gold mine.
All right. I'm gonna take everything you said into consideration, okay? The family business is what's at stake right now, all right? But Victor, this is your last chance to work towards keeping up the Diluca name. You make it happen, you don't fuck it up, okay? Or else you're out of the family business for good.
Understood. What, no kiss?
Screw you.
Come in.
Great. I have been calling your phone.
Before you say anything, let me first apologize to you, okay? For Jarell's behavior at the salon. Me and him spoke and I told him that it was unacceptable the way he acted. Mm-hmm. He had to find somewhere else to work.
Wait, is it going to rain? You actually seen something my way for a change?
It wasn't about seeing it your way. It's about what was right. And I think you should humble yourself a little bit more.
Humble myself?
Yeah, because I can be a jerk and say I own a place, but I don't. And I treat you and Kiko the same.
Brandon, I don't have an attitude problem. And what the hell is wrong with your hand?
Macen, I'm here to tell you, you have an attitude problem. And I mean that in the nicest way. And my hand...
Well, what...
Oh my fucking
what
god!
The hell?
Me and Ashton just got in a fight to the park.
Well, Ashton,
you and Ashton fighting for what?
Whoa, what happened to you? Looking a little rough.
Me and Kiko got in a big fight earlier. This bitch morphed into a pit bull and started attacking me over Winston.
That's why you come here.
Yeah. I mean, she busted and caught me and Winston on the floor having sex. It was a big nightmare. I mean, I tried to tell her what happened, but she didn't want to listen to me.
Are you surprised? I mean, you're sleeping with her man?
Winston is not Kiko's man. This bitch just went psycho on me.
Good. And what does that make you?
Huh?
I mean, you know, we both are fighting over scraps. I thought you learned your lesson by now, but let's stand corrected.
And what is that supposed to mean?
You're pathetic. And you wasted my time by bringing me here to tell me this bull.
I see someone said the mood swings again.
This ain't about no damn mood swings. This is about reality. And how you just been a real disappointment lately?
Oh, so you're living this perfect, huh?
Oh, I'm far from it. But you know, I'm not the one going around letting the enemy plow my back out, but you know, cut from two different cloths.
You know what, Derrick? I don't even know who you are anymore. I've been over backwards time and time again for you. Hell, I even found out who your dad was. And this is how you repay me?
Want a cookie? Done whining? I mean, Kiko needs to beat your ass. Somebody had to knock some sense into your head.
You know what, Derrick? Goodbye. Get out of my store.
Okay.
I guess the truth hurts, you know.
Ashton was sleeping with Winston.
Macen.
What?
She is pouring harder and all you can do is laugh.
Cuz, child, this is a fucking mess. You mean to tell me Ashton is sleeping with another man connected to Phallon?
I see why they both best friends. They both some hoes. You shouldn't be friends with them anyway.
Well, Ashton was telling me that Winston was pretending to like me and Phallon put him up to it.
Ho, 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 ho. That's your future sister-in-law? You need to go to that office and check that
out. Oh, hell no. Nah. I'm not getting in that. Jabril and finally got too much going on already, and I'm not starting no feud to that fire.
Well, I ain't scared of that trick. I'm going up there and give her a piece of my mind and find out some answers.
Listen, Kiko, listen. Hold up. Once all this is said and done, I need to really, like, you really need to relax. Calm down and reevaluate your life, because it's so fucked up right now.
You're the one to talk. Talking to a monster son?
Sweetheart, that's being handled right now as we speak.
Well, Brandon, did you find out about Derrick? Did you find him?
Well, since y'all both acquiring me, I did run into that punk at Rob's house.
He fucked you up.
I let my fist do the talking.
You whooped his ass?
I tried to, but he got leukemia.
Well,
leukemia?
Well, leukemia didn't...
What?
Didn't give him a motive to throw that ass in a circle on Jabril.
Kiko does have a point.
Well, what? Kiko, since you have so much mouth, how about you go down to Phallon's office and check her?
Oh, I am. I'm going right up there, but first I need to change my clothes because I need to look glamorous before I open up the library and read that ass for filth.
Yeah, because right now you were giving me anime Bullock. That wig is twisted.
Is it really that bad?
Yes, you look terrible.
Well, you should see Ashton. I dragged him.
Wait, please don't tell me you pulled out his hair. I just got it to grow.
I pulled it. Because you know he's bigger than me.
You pinched him. You at least...
I'll fuck them up. I get some bows.
You were fighting Ashton.
Yeah.
You beat up Derrick.
Best friends.
Don't want it.
Get your hand together. I gotta go to the salon.
I'm about to go get some wine. You thirsty?
Can you Advil with a bottle of water, please?
Okay, I'll get some
Advil.
Take care of you.
She looks like Kiko with you.
No, leave her here with you. Bye.
All right.
Thank you for coming to meet me.
Well, this is a surprise.
Well, I figured I would have to see what my man is doing and steal some quality time.
Hold on, I'm your man, and after you cussed me out last night and left, I didn't know what was up. Okay, so how can I help you this afternoon, bro? What's in the bag?
Well, I came to bring a peace offering for some lunch.
Oh, that's a...
Yeah, and I'm sorry for throwing up at you.
Oh. Well, isn't this some foreign language coming out of your mouth?
Don't be an asshole.
I'm just messing with you. I guess I'm sorry, too.
Kiko, why are we meeting here?
Oh, this is the spot Winston took me on our first date.
So why the hell are you dressed like you coming from the Oscars?
This whole thing, I came here to talk to you.
Like that? Dressed like that?
I wore this outfit just for you. I wanted to feel like $1 million when I came here to read you for being the backstabber that you are.
Backstabber? Kiko, what the hell are you talking about now?
You heard me. Do I need to spell it out for you?
First of all, Kiko, spelling requires a little bit of education, something you clearly do not have.
Oh, just sit there, just thinking you're the queen bee. You're not. I wouldn't be surprised if you need a colonic to clean out that ass of yours.
Clearly, the home shopping network has gone to your skull. What's wrong with you?
I tell you my problem. I know you told Winston to pretend to like me.
Who told you that?
Don't worry, just know your secret is out. What did I ever do to deserve this?
Have you forgotten that you blackmailed me twice? Twice, Kiko.
I know what I did was wrong, but I just want to experience what it would be like to be in your shoes. But I came to realize that all glitter's not gold. You truly let all this power and money get to your head.
Well, I'm used to it. I allowed you to get a little taste of it. Clearly, consider yourself cut off. So you better hope that you can take that shabby-ass Chanel bag back to Neiman's. I heard they got a little strict policy on their returns.
I don't need the money. I don't need the bags anymore.
I beg to differ.
You can't play God with people's feelings and thinking that's okay. You really hurt me.
So you were mad.
Yes, but not really.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I was annoyed, but not enough to be really upset.
Annoyed about what, Jabril?
Annoyed at the fact that we were fighting over people that don't matter to us.
I know, but I just can't have somebody keep on disrespecting us like that.
I understand, I'm the same way, but I don't want you to think I want Derrick. That's long gone over with, and I think I've been a lot to show that I've changed, so I just need you to trust that.
I do trust you, and I do believe you, but I can't lie and say that I'm comfortable with everything I'm hearing.
I understand, but we're not good. It's nothing to worry about, so we're good.
Okay, so what are you gonna do about Jarell?
Sure. I want to send his ass back to his mom, but I'm giving him one last chance to get himself together, I guess.
Well, hopefully he finds some way to work at Easton, because you know he can't come to the shop.
Yeah, I know. He means no one back. I bet you he was happy to kick him out.
Don't start that.
But I'm going to take him out for drinks later, and I guess I owe him an apology too.
Yes, you do.
I don't think so. But I just don't want to come off as a father to him. I want to be a brother, but it seems like I gotta be plain daddy. I don't want that.
But it seems like the only person they listen to is you, so step up.
Yeah, I guess. Anyway, we can eat this in the cafeteria down here because upstairs is a mess. I have to tell you about that situation with Phallon later on.
Okay.
So yeah, let's go get something to eat. I mean, that's really the only reason why I would apologize.
You look nice.
Thank you.
Kiko, I'm sorry that I'm not sorry, but life is like a game of chess. When you go up against someone, you make sure you learn their every move, and then you play to win, because baby, I don't lose.
You didn't win yet.
You poor delusional thing. Listen, I suggest that you take the rest of that little bit of money that you have, buy you some more trashy gowns, and trashy get-up wigs, because I hear you'll be a hit on vaudeville.
I'll do just that. And first, you gotta dust off those cobwebs in between your legs, because no man wanna go down in the attic.
I have no problems in that department, I thank you very much.
You sent him with a smirk on your face thinking you won, but I ain't finished yet. You forgot one important thing about the game of chess. Don't move your queen so early. Who's left to protect your knight?
You know what, you're lucky like somebody like Winston even paid you any mind. Look at you. Kiko, get out. Goodbye. It's time for you to go.
You think you're so smart and savvy.
I am.
You don't know what Winston's doing behind your back.
I'm sure you're going to run that mouth and tell me.
It's my pleasure. Just think it is my parting gift to you. Winston is fucking Ashton behind your back.
Kiko, get out. That's a good one.
Ask him yourself. I saw him fucking with my own two eyes. So who's the queen bitch now? Check me.
I've never been to a restaurant with nobody in it. Did you buy the whole place out?
We'll discuss that. What are we here for?
Well, I'm actually glad that you decided to meet me in such short notice. I kind of just wanted to talk.
I was at the house earlier to talk with your father. You were nowhere to be found. Where were you?
I went for a walk. I needed to clear my brain for a long walk. What did you discuss with Victor?
You know, dealings with your father, my brother, don't go in the way that I see fit for our family. It's not in the way that we were raised. And if my father was still here, seeing how Victor is now, my father would have hung himself. Trying to talk some sense into him.
I'm assuming you're talking about the whole Eve thing. And to be honest, I don't really get that whole arrangement. Was your father as crazy as Victor is now?
Your father never elaborated much on your grandfather?
I mean, not really. He always said that he was never ever given the liberty in doing what he wants to do, and he never really wanted to be in the business, and that I was very lucky for, you know, having such liberty that he was never afforded to.
Look, my father came here from Sicily with not much more than a dime in his pocket. Okay? By the age of 30, my father ran numbers, and then he became... By the time of 30, my father ran shit. Okay? Now, Jesus, this is something we're born into. Okay? This is something we're given. This is something we need to accept and something we need to respect, whether we like it or not. Luckily for me, I have a passion for this business.
How could I? I mean, Victor wouldn't even accept the fact that I'm gay.
Jesus, I have to be a little honest with you. You know, when I found out you were gay, I was hurt. That hurt me. But, you know, I need to respect the fact that this is the choice that you made.
Choice? Being gay wasn't a choice for me. I didn't just wake up and say, hey, I want to be gay. Do you think I would just walk every day dealing with this ridicule if I had a choice?
Honey, it's not ridicule. It's how you execute, okay? And being a mobster and having a son that's gay, that's a sign of weakness, okay? So I don't care who you're with, I don't care what you're doing, but I don't want you to broadcast anything, okay? There's no need for our enemies to subject us to anything else. They don't need to know anything. Do you understand me?
I understand. I'm not broadcasting anything.
Hey, Derrick. You look like you was about to go somewhere.
I thought I was in the wrong place. So I was gonna leave.
Yeah. Did you get what I asked?
Yeah, but I don't even...
What the fuck is this?
That's all I could find.
Derrick, I asked you to bring me anything dealing with Davenport Industries or my wife. What is this bullshit?
Look, I told you Rob doesn't just leave shit lying around the house. Doesn't have anything.
Who the fuck is she?
I don't know. It was just this picture and some other papers. That's all I could find.
Derrick? I thought you was a lot smarter than that, Derrick. I didn't want it to get ugly between us.
Why don't you just find some other way to get back at that bitch? And leave me out of it.
Derrick, you brought yourself into it. That night you came to my house looking for my wife. Remember that night? Derrick.
Get off of this shit.
Derrick, you should be used to me by now. I mean, me and Rob are just alike.
Well, he doesn't repulse me the way that you do.
Really? That's funny. I mean, we're both nice to look at. We're both charming. Suave.
Shut up. Are you done here? Because I have somewhere I need to
I didn't dismiss you yet, Derrick. And we're a long way from done.
I told you to just find another fucking way.
You're right, Derrick. I'm sorry. You know what? I'll just go to Rob's apartment myself. That's what the fuck I'll do. I'll go to Rob's apartment myself. I'll probably wait till it's late, sneak in while he sleeps, catch him off guard. That should be fun.
I'm not going fucking where near Rob,
no,
okay?
Going anywhere. You're so fucking tough. You love him, huh? Derrick. Stop playing games.
You stop fucking playing games with me. And if you keep pushing me, I'm going to put a 6 bullet in your fucking chest.
Derrick. You fucking threaten a man like me. You might want to make sure your ass can deliver. I will fucking end you. And I won't think nothing about it. Not a damn thing. You understand? So what are we going to do, Derrick? Are you going to go to Rob's apartment or am I?
Fine. I do it, but this is the last time. And I'm so serious about this, Clint.
That's up to you, Derrick. It's up to you. Give me what I need. And I hope this is the last time, Derrick. You can go. See you soon. Little sweet ass.
But I'm not gonna change who I am for anyone. I don't care who it is.
Look, nobody's asking you to change. Growing up wasn't easy for anybody, not even your father. When it came to my father ruled with an iron fist. Sometimes that iron fist was up against your father's skull. Take that into consideration.
Probably fucking deserved it. Was there... Did they get physical often?
There was a rough patch. There was a time when it was really bad. My father broke my brother's ribs. But we get past it.
I'm sorry, I'm not the same person.
The same person as what?
I'm not gonna stand by and let somebody tell me what I can or cannot do. I'm sorry. Like you said, it's in our blood.
Again, this is something that we were born into. Okay? You can choose who you want to be with, but the one thing I will not allow you to choose is straying away from this family. Okay? I remember when you were born. There was such an awe when we saw you. You were the future of this family. Your father looked at you with so much pride, hoping that one day you would be sitting head of this table too, possibly heading your own family. But with you broadcasting your sexuality, it's become a fairy tale. Don't get upset. You need to stay strong. Scared money don't make money. Okay?
I
don't
want to
see your fear. I don't want to see your weakness. You be which, who you be, but you do it with your head up. Okay? You want me to accept you? You accept us. And us meaning the family. You got that?
I understand.
You think you can do that? You like men, can you be a man?
I will no longer disappoint our family or bring any problems to it, that matter.
Look around. You see this? It's empty. You think you can head something? You think you're finally ready to take control of something? I'll give it to you. You can take this, and you can start this business and start your own money. And you're gonna learn from the ground up. You're gonna go in there, you're gonna wash dishes, you're gonna come out, and you're gonna be the head of everything. You're gonna start with this restaurant right here. Show me what you can do. Make me believe in you.
And I can do that. I can. This whole situation just...
Get your father out of your head, all right?
You don't live with the guy.
Honey, I'm his sister. I grew up with the man, okay? You don't want to be like your father, so don't. Cut this fucking pussy shit out, all right? Do what the fuck you have to do. Take this business, start from here, and show me your worth. Show me it doesn't matter if you suck dick or not. Do you have what it takes?
I do. I... You're crazy. You are crazy. All right, I get it. I get it, Vicky.
Oh, Jesus, I can't with you sometimes. I really can't.
All right, there's no need.
You
don't have
my
to talk
soft
about...
spot, all right? Your father... That's another story.
We don't have to talk about my personal life anymore. It's not a matter in this situation.
Are you going to make us money?
I will do what it takes.
You want the power? Do you want the money? Do you want the respect?
I will do whatever it takes to make it to where I want to be.
Good. I hate to cut this dinner short, but I have to go. I love you.
Not so soon.
Tell your father I said bye.
Be safe, Aunt Vicky.
Thanks for inviting me here, bro. I really needed this.
Yeah, I kind of needed to, I guess apologize for the other night for jumping down your neck. I'm not trying to be your damn father, but I need you to get your act together.
I mean, I understand. I definitely will. And I will say, I'll apologize for jumping into you and Brandon's little altercation that wasn't right of me.
So, did you do what I asked? How's the search coming along? Any progress?
About that.
Oh, what? What's up? What's the problem?
Well, I mean, I did apply to the job that you sent me, but I didn't submit anything because, shit, everything started off at like $15 an hour. Who the hell can survive off of that around here?
A lot of people can do it. And at this point, you don't have a choice. What was the job anyway? What was so bad about it?
It was for some file clerk at a law firm.
And what's the problem with it?
I mean, nothing. If you like working in a dark room and just organizing and filing shit all day. But me, I like to vibe amongst people, you know?
Okay. So what other skills do you have outside of that?
I mean, I dibble-dabble a little bit. Took a job here and there, so I got a couple skills up my sleeve, but, I mean, nothing too serious.
And school, what did you go to school for again?
Besides barbering, I mean, I went to school for criminal justice, so.
You ever thought about being a security guard?
A security guard? Hell no. Why would you ask that?
It's entry level, criminal justice, what's wrong with it?
If you, you know, consider yourself a fake RoboCop and, you know, like wearing schmedium uniforms, then I mean, I guess it's cool, but nah, not me.
Okay, so you like to be bobbing around the people. Let's bring it. So, what about customer service, maybe salesperson?
Hell no. Man, I can't deal with people in their funky-ass attitudes. I swear, one person get an attitude with me, I will black the fuck out.
Oh, like you did with Macen.
Exactly how I did with Macen.
Honestly, between you and I'm glad you're not working here. I mean, I can't even stand Macen. He has a nasty-ass attitude, and he's too fucking nosy.
Man, look, I'm telling you, I was 2 seconds off cracking his fucking skull. He lucky Kiko came in when she did. I don't know how the hell you deal with they crazy asses.
Oh, I don't. I don't even go in that shop. It's like a loony bin with fucking hair dryers.
They that lit in there?
And I was hoping when I bought Brandon the shop that he would kind of rein in some of that craziness. But he got some type of soft spot for them, so I gotta deal with it now.
Oh, so you throwing money like that, huh? Guess he must be throwing it that good.
Excuse me?
I'm just joking, bro. I'm just joking.
Yeah, I didn't find it funny. No, but actually, it was just a business investment on my part, so.
Yeah. So, I mean, since you're doing business investments, how about throwing a couple stacks at your little brother for a second?
Jarell, the only thing that I'm going to be throwing is your ass out on the curb if you don't find a damn job.
Who is that snow bunny down there?
Man, calm your hormones. That's Naomi. We used to work the same shift here, so.
You used to work here?
Yeah, it was actually kind of fun, too. Especially when we had these private parties. Mm-hmm. I'll tell you, tips was crazy.
Tips in this place?
Yeah.
Bro, it's empty as fuck in here. How the hell?
It's a weekday. I already trust me.
Well, I mean, she fine as hell, though, so.
Calm down. But, how are you around liquor and drinks and stuff?
I mean, I'm pretty good around the bar. I mean, I know my liquor, so I guess I'm good.
Okay, so how would you feel about maybe working here? I could talk to my old manager and see, you know, if anything's open. I know you could probably do like $200 to maybe $500 a night on a good busy night.
Word? Yeah. Well, shit, sign me up and show me where to apply. Especially if it's going to be like...
Listen, if I talk to him and I get you this job, I don't want it to be no shit. Do you understand?
Man, look, don't sweat me. I promise you, I got you.
Oh, no, it's either this or you going back home.
Look, I promise you I'll be good. I mean, I can still look though, right? She is like...
I'll be right back.
Man, you still working around here? Hey, Naomi. Can I get a refill?
Sure. I can't believe we're actually here by ourselves on a date. I mean, it's a lot different from being cooped up in my apartment.
It was time that we explored us outside of the confines of the house. I can't help but to sense some apprehension on your face.
Just a little.
I specifically chose this place because it's quaint and discreet. No one really comes here.
Yeah, but do you know the big leap we're taking with all of this? I'm just nervous that it's gonna all just blow up in our faces. And then look at you sitting there as if you're not scared or afraid of anything.
That's because I stopped fearing a long time ago. Fear is what kept us from reaching our full potential with one another. I mean, could you imagine just how much farther we could be if you stopped fearing this?
You're right. I don't know, I just have to get that feeling out of me that someone's just gonna pull the rug from under me. And I'll admit, you've proven yourself time and time again. I mean, shit, you even taught me how to be much stronger, something I wouldn't even imagine for my own self.
I really appreciate you saying that. And I think that's something that I've needed to hear quite some time. But I have to be honest. I can't say that I don't feel bad about Kiko finding out. Have you at least spoken to her?
Yeah, I met up with her earlier and things went south and sour. I mean, do you think she's gonna tell Phallon what happened?
No, no. Because if Phallon knew, she would have called me right now.
Okay, and what's stopping Kiko from blabbing her big ass mouth?
I'll go and talk to Kiko, convince her to keep quiet.
What is that supposed to mean? You're not gonna hurt Kiko, are you?
No, that's not necessary. I'm going to use the power of persuasion. And a check. Because we know how much Kiko likes her money.
Yeah, but she's gonna soon find out that material things run everything. That's the thing, you know so much about me. And I don't know anything about you. Like, when's the last relationship you had?
A few years ago.
Okay, so how long were you in it? Were you in love? Does Winston fall in love?
Let's not talk about that right now.
I mean, what? I'm just trying to make conversation. You don't have to back out on me now.
Hey, Ashton, I'm not holding anything back. I promise you, everything you want to know about me, you will know in due time. But I am just more concerned with us focusing on us right now.
Yeah. That's the thing. I didn't know how you were when I first met you. I mean, given the circumstances, I thought you were just somebody who had no life outside of the Davenport.
That's the funny thing. Maybe I never did. Because since I've met you, this is the first time in my life that I have felt completely uninhibited and free. It's almost as if my emotions were lying dormant, and I didn't even realize it. And when you came along, and woke me up.
Wow. So are you inhibited and free from Phallon?
I mean, I guess you could say that, but...
Oh my God. Sorry. Don't tell me I spoke her up.
Yeah.
Go ahead and answer, I don't care.
No, it can wait.
Are you sure?
Very. Actually, one better. I'll cut it off. So this shows you that you have my complete and undivided attention.
Look, it's over. Phallon found everything out. Of course I have proof. Look, you told me that this would be a piece of cake. I'm not taking a fall for this alone. If I go down, you're going down with me. Look, you need to meet me. And no more excuses.
Raven. Raven, don't you raise your voice at me again. I thought you were up for this job. It's obvious you got sloppy. And now I gotta come behind you and clean this shit up. If my plan is ruined, you don't have to worry about Phallon coming after you, because I'm gonna come after you myself. Do you understand me? Goodbye.
Coming. Hello.
I'm looking for Jabril. You must be Brandon.
Yeah. And you are?
I'm his sister, Claudia.
Was he expecting you?
I was gonna surprise him. I'm sure you've heard all about me.
No, not really. Never knew you existed.
Huh? Not even through the grapevine?
Nope. Only person I hear about is, Phallon.
Oh, well, that doesn't surprise me, given that Phallon has enough drama to fill up a psych ward.
Damn!
Are you going to invite me in? It's rather chilly out.
Oh, I mean, come in. Make yourself comfortable, I guess.
Derrick, what are you doing in my apartment?
Get back.
Move back.
Leave that.
Where are you going? You were trying to steal from me?
No.
You were trying to steal these papers.
No.
And you're still lying to my face.
Well, this is quite the bachelor pad. Very rustic and urban.
Are you trying to call this place ghetto?
Oh, heavens no. I would never say that. What I meant was, you know, it's just, Jabril's taste has always been rather refined, which is why seeing you here is a little odd.
Is there a problem?
really. It's just that when Jabril said he had a boyfriend, I imagined you looking a bit different.
And what's wrong with how I look?
A lack of refinement, that's all.
Would you rather me put on some clothes?
Would you mind?
Yes. So, I mean, what's your name again?
Claudia. I know it's not a name you hear very often.
Yeah, you're right. I'm used to like the Ebony's, Lisa's, Keisha. Claudia kind of reminds me of one of those older names, you know, snotty, much like yourself.
For your information, my name dates back to the 16th century. It was usually saved for the aristocratic families.
I mean, whatever makes you feel better, I guess.
Is Jabril upstairs?
No, he's actually with Brandon.
I thought you were Brandon.
Nope.
Say something.
Please, just get that back. And all this is gonna be over.
What are you talking about?
I can't say.
So you break into my apartment. You try to steal from me. And you can't tell me why? Derrick, what type of games are you playing?
It's not a game. I'm supposed to come in, I'm supposed to leave, I'm supposed to drop all of this, and you just messed it up.
Me? You're not even supposed to have these papers in your possession. And I'm not letting you out of my sight until you tell me what's going on.
If I don't go back with something, he's gonna think something's up. He might come after you next.
Who are you talking about?
Clint!
What?
Yes. I promise you I did not want to do any of this and put me up to it.
So Clint made you break into my apartment?
Yes.
Why? Where is he?
You wouldn't understand. I have a choice.
Listen, Derrick, it's not making any sense. Why won't you just tell me?
Understand.
Listen, I'm gonna have to call Phallon.
Don't, please, you cannot say anything.
Why, are you afraid of him?
Yes! Look, the truth cannot come out. Put the damn phone down.
Why are you so afraid of him?
Because I shot him!
You shot Clint? After all this time, you're telling me this now?
I'm scared. I thought he died.
Ashton went to jail. He almost had to go on trial for something he didn't do.
I was scared to come forward. What if he had died? I would be facing life in prison.
Do you even know what this means now?
Please, you cannot say anything. If you love me, just keep the secret between us. Can I trust you?
Yes. But what is Clint gonna tell?
He said he wouldn't say anything. But I will have to help him take down Phallon.
By stealing from me? Where's the papers you stole from me?
I gave it to him already. Who's that girl that was in the pictures?
None of your business. Look, I'm not letting you leave until you tell me exactly what happened that night. And we have to figure out how we're going to fix this Clint situation.
Well, who the hell are you?
I'm Jarell. Jabril's half-brother. Nice to meet you.
Oh my god. Another illegitimate offspring.
Is that your way of calling me a bastard?
You said it, I didn't.
Yo, you really need to get this stick out of your ass.
For your information, I don't have a stick up my ass.
You do. But I mean, maybe I could take it out and, you know, help you replace it with something a little more.
Gross. You reek of Ciroc and beer.
Do I offend you?
Yes. You're not my type.
You never know until you try.
Yeah. Well, the next time I'm in the market for a pubescent thug, I'll give you a call. Don't hold your breath.
Do you want to leave a message?
Not with you. I'll call Jabril myself and tell him I'm staying at the Estonian.
Well, you just do that.
Learn some manners next time.
Meeting. Well, it looked like you had a good time.
I did.
What school, I guess? I actually might like Jerome now.
But hey, no telling that. Yeah.
But that's good to hear.
Yeah, I even talked to my old boss down at Indigo and I got him a bartending job.
Wow. He must be growing on you.
What do you say like that for?
Because I wouldn't be expecting you to be helping him.
Look, I'm hoping that he can fit in into that atmosphere. I mean, he's new in town. He can meet some people, mingle, you know.
Fast money.
Exactly. So he can get out of our house. It works, right? See, I can mentor him from, like, across town, maybe even out of the state. Works.
Just when I thought you were being nice, here you go.
Listen, give me some credit. I'm not used to dealing with a dependent sibling. I don't deal with this with my sisters, okay?
Well, it seems like you had a good time. Did Jarell enjoy himself?
Did he? And then the liquor kicked in, and I had to pull him off of every fucking female that walked by. I took his ass home.
So you dropped him off and came here?
Yup.
Maybe you should have stayed home. I got a long day tomorrow. I gotta wake up early. Bedtime, so.
I came because it's bedtime. I figured we could sleep. I missed you. I haven't seen you in a while.
And you think you really want to be laying down?
Well, I don't know about, we'll lay down, but I don't know about sleeping.
Hey, Phallon. I came as soon as I could. Everything all right?
Yeah, don't worry about it. I took care of everything myself.
Are you sure there's nothing that I could be of assistance with?
Yeah, I'm positive. You've done so much for me, I was just sitting here thinking of ways that I could possibly repay you.
Phallon, you don't owe me anything. It's my job to be right where you need me.
You know what, Winston? You've done so much for me. You helped me get my life back together. You helped me when times I was down and out and you never judged me. Like, how did I become such a lucky woman?
Luck has nothing to do with it. You are a remarkable woman. You know, the average person would have crumbled in your circumstances. But you, on the other hand, have become all the more resilient. It's quite amazing.
I just don't know. I don't know how much more fight I have left in me. You know, when you're on top, it seems like everybody wants to take your spot.
Phallon, don't even talk like that.
Well, it's true. Jabril finally got what he wanted. I stepped down as CEO today.
What? Phallon, why would you do that?
I didn't want to give up the 25% that I've acquired.
And why didn't you call me?
That's just it, Winston. I've been calling. You haven't been answering your phone.
That's what it is.
I was across town doing business, and I must have had bad reception. This is crazy.
This has been one of the worst days of my entire life. I didn't deserve this. Do you think I deserve this?
Deserve it? Of course not.
You know, I was thinking back to the time when my dad was teaching me how to ride a bike. He told me to get to the corner and get back. And of course, on the third try, I got down to the corner, but I fell coming back. I fell so hard. And I cried even harder, you know. But he came over to me and said, "Phallon, tears are for the weak. You know, don't nobody feel sorry for a loser." I'm so sick of it, Winston. I'm sick of fighting and fighting my tears. I'm tired.
Well, Baron always had a way of saying exactly how it felt, no matter how brutal or harsh it might have come across.
It's crazy. Everybody looks at me and they say, "Oh, Fallon's a villain. Fallon doesn't have a heart." But that's not true. You know, I have a heart. You know, I've just been hurt so many times.
Fallon, you and I both know the heart that you have. People who don't see that, don't see it because they don't deserve to know the real you.
Well, you and my father are the only men that I've ever trusted, so I hope that you'll never, ever betray me.
Of course I wouldn't betray you.
Well, on a lighter note, I need to hear some good news.
Okay.
How are things going with you and Kiko?
They're going great.
Really?
She's a really sweet girl. Okay. Kind of surprised. I'm actually taking her out tonight.
Oh, good. Well, I wouldn't want to keep you. I've held you up long enough, so get up and get out of here.
Are you sure? We're having a bit of a moment. I don't want to leave you.
It's all right. I don't want to be sad no more. Just get up and go. Have fun.
Okay. Well, duty calls as usual.
All right.
All right, Rose.
Winston, one thing. You know, ever since Victor tied Kiko and Ashton up in that box, they become really, really close. Have you seen Ashton lately?
No. I haven't seen Ashton. I haven't seen Mr. Banks since before summer.
Maybe. Oh, okay, I thought maybe you would have seen him. But it's okay. But, okay. Because...
You all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. I was thinking... I think I want you to get rid of him.
Why?
Why are you questioning me? And why the surprised look on your face?
Well, I just wasn't expecting that to be what you said. I thought that we were done with him.
Excuse me, since when do I need justification? I need you to find him and kill him.
Don't understand.
What do you mean?
Why don't we focus on Jabril right now? That's what's relevant. We can come back to Ashton later.
What's wrong with you, Winston? Take care of him tonight.
As you wish.
Thank you.
All right, Rose.
Oh, one last thing, Winston.
Yes.
How long have you been fucking Ashton?
Excuse me?
You heard me. How long have you been fucking Ashton?
Can we do it again? what you're doing.
What are you talking about?
I'm gonna ask you one more time. How long have you been fucking Ashton?
What do you want me to say?
Listen, I am doing everything in my power not to get up and strangle you! Winston, look me in my eyes and tell me the truth.
Please, just calm down for a second.
I can't believe you!
I never meant to hurt you. I'm sorry.
You're the only man that I've ever trusted besides my father. How could you hurt me like this? How could you do this to me?
It wasn't about you. It was about my heart.
How was your heart? Me! I can't believe you.
Sorry.
Just go. You take a good look at my face. You look at me because I never, ever want to see you again.
Wait, just listen to me.
You can show up to my doorstep gasping for air. And I'll leave you standing there, dying a slow death. You know everything I've been through with men. You know this. Get out! Get out, Winston! Get out!
You really mean that?
Yes. Go.
Wait, just wait!
Go! Just go! I don't want to look at you.
Like some family.